سنتك يا بيتر.
يعطيكم العافية. Good afternoon. مثل العادي حيكون معنا لقاء يومي مع ضيوفنا الكرام من قناة كندانا وقناة الدكتور جمال الشريف. اليوم معنا ضيف خاص. اليوم معنا special guest. So I'm going to speak mostly in English, and as we promised you, later on the episode will continue, and me and Dr. Jamal will talk to you about what we talked in Arabic to Peter, to Member of Parliament Peter Fonseca. However, that will be for the Arab audience, and it will be after. Right now, to all Canadians, to all Ontarians, to all Mississaugans, thank you very much for tuning in. And I'm going to start with an introduction to a person who I consider him a very good family friend and my favorite member of parliament. And I mean it. I mean it. He is very big. A lot of time you see his hand touch, but and you see what he done, but you don't see him everywhere. Peter Fonseca, how are you today?
Sam, I'm good. I hope that you're well. All of your supporters are doing well, that they're healthy, they're safe, their families, your family, and all Mississaugans, Ontarians, and Canadians are keeping safe and ensuring that that their loved ones are safe at this very difficult time.
Awesome, awesome. Peter, let's start with this. Can you tell me, what do you think of the crisis that we are going through right now? Let's give this like a couple moments and hear you, hear your thoughts about it before anything.
Yeah, I think this is, as all Canadians and people around the world are feeling, this is unprecedented. We've not experienced anything like this, both how it's affecting our countries, our, you know, how people are feeling in terms of anxiety. And we feel it on the ground every single day as parliamentarians. And as the Prime Minister Trudeau has said, we are here to do everything possible, everything in our power to ensure that Canadians are stay safe, are as healthy as possible, and that we can keep both Canadians and the businesses that keep our economy running whole. So that, as the Prime Minister has said, everything is on the table. We will do anything and everything, as long as well as with our partners, the provinces, the municipalities, the territories, to ensure that the Canadians, first off, are safe and are kept healthy, and secondly, to address the pressures that are coming in terms of economic pressures, job loss, or the like, with businesses in terms of what they're experiencing.
Awesome. Awesome. It is a very tough times. And today is just about myself, my 10th day at home. I started a bit early because I felt the heat. I'm very close followers, and my audience know my style in this. So I follow other countries. I follow the news before it happened. So I knew about this 2 weeks ago. My shopping were done a month ago. And when I really seen it called by the WHO, the World Health Organization, I stayed home from that day. So it's been 10 days for me at home. And I mean home, tight home. I don't get out except to my backyard with my kids. That being said, I think our audience today wanted to talk about financials. Lots of families are going to suffer through this. Average families, under average, general Canadians, they're going to suffer from this. Business owners, small business owners, daycare providers, all those people are anxious, they're worried about their health, but at the same time, they're worried about their good well-being or well-being and their family well-being and their financials. And they have put out about 10 questions. I'm sure they have 50 questions, but we took 10 questions that are important for them to try to answer them. And who better to ask than a member of parliament, Peter Fonseca, who is his eyes on the scene, and he's there, he's very involved. So as much, I know it is new, I understand that. And I know maybe the government theirself is still implementing some things. So I'm quite sure nothing is put in places yet, 100%. But as much as we can answer to our viewers and our audience, and again, not only people who watch this right now, usually our videos go about 10,000 or 20,000 afterward because people start sharing them. Sure. So everybody who's going to watch this, I hope they benefit from it. We did the introduction and we're going to go to the first question. Dr. Jamal, I'll ask you kindly and please, so we could continue this conversation after. If you could take any notes from what Peter Fonseca is going to say, I would really appreciate that. What is the government doing for Canadians financially and non-financially, Peter?
Sam, first, I just wanted to go back to how we commenced this conversation. And thank you and those like you that have taken this preventative approach to isolating themselves, to making sure that they implement best practices, washing their hands, keeping a social distance, 2 meters from each other, because we're all in this together and we're all helping each other. Our brothers and sisters, our neighbors, our friends, everybody is helping one another by dealing with this, by taking on these best practices and understanding how important that they are. That being said, as we are able to do this, there are people like Dr. Jamal, healthcare providers, people that work in grocery stores, people that are work in transportation, truckers, people flying planes, bringing goods in boats, etc., that keep us being able to get the supplies we need, medical supplies, food supplies, being able to service our most vulnerable population, those that are sick, and they are all on the front lines. And it is up to us to do our part to also stay isolated, to wash our hands, to implement social distancing. It is imperative because we have to think how much they are doing for us by putting themselves on the front lines, that us taking, you know, our precautions will help everybody in the end. And I hope people, and I know people are taking this very seriously. The good thing that I've seen come out of, COVID-19 is how Canadian values have been heightened and how people have been much more respectful of each other, understanding of each other, and how we are all working together. And when I say this, I don't say this just for the public, but I also say this in politics, to see that that we have put partisanship aside and we have all parties coming together, all levels of government, provinces, municipalities, the territories, the federal government, everybody working hand in glove to make sure, again, that we keep Canadians safe and healthy, and that we are also able to support our frontline workers and with their health, as well as addressing the economic challenges. Sam, you brought up the economic challenges, and this is something that is affecting all of us. And because of that, we have taken extraordinary measures to be able to address the economic impact this is having on Canadians. So the Prime Minister announced a number of packages. One was $27 billion in direct support to workers and families. And then there was another $55 billion that was help for businesses in terms of deferrals, remittances, etc., in terms of when they have to pay taxes that they would owe to the government. Beyond that $82 billion, there was also $300 billion that was put in through the banks for more liquidity in our economy. So what has this done? I'll just give you on the ground what this means to many people, many, many workers. Of course, those workers that are eligible for employment insurance and have lost their job, before there used to be a one-week waiting period before you can apply. We have waived that period. Now you can apply right away. Secondly, we have brought something forward that has never been done before, and that is workers that were not eligible for employment insurance. That may be sole proprietors. That may be individuals that work contract to contract, those type of individuals in the gig economy. They are now eligible to get up to $450 per week or $900 biweekly, $1,800 over the month. And that now that application process for those individuals, because that is so new, such a new program, it's never been done before. This is, as I said, extraordinary. Will be coming online through the CRA website, through the canada.gov.ca. And through the CRA, you'll be able to apply in April and be able to apply for that program. Here is because we are opening up the program to all workers. There is one thing in the program. You will have to do an attestation just to say, this is really happening to me, and this is why I need the support. And every couple of weeks, as you receive those monies, you will also do that attestation that you're still not able to work because you're taking care of a loved one at home that's in isolation or somebody that needs that your support.
That will be done at home on your computer, just so everybody understands. We're not going to go nowhere. We are already in isolation.
That's right. Yes. You could do it over your computer, right through your CRA account or your Service Canada account that you would already have.
Okay.
Or there will also be a phone number that people will be able to call. And so through that vehicle, people will be able to receive those much needed funds as quickly as possible. The other thing is through the Canada Child Benefit, I'll just say we are going to increase the amount that people will be receiving through the Canada Child Benefit for the foreseeable future. So what that will mean, so the next month, an average family receiving the child benefit will receive on average an extra $550. So that's another benefit.
But child or for the family?
That would be a family. So I wanted to give you the average because, of course, every family is different.
Definitely.
Sometimes they have one child, two children. They may have one parent, two parents. So it all depends on income, etc. So but on average, $550. Okay.
Awesome.
Yeah. So we have a number of other things. So some of our the GST tax credit that is received for, I'll give you an example, individuals that make $44,000 or less. They get a quarterly GST tax credit. That tax credit, we will be providing a one-time payment also on that tax credit of an extra $400 that will be coming in as part of that tax credit. So that will also help individuals. We're trying to find ways to be able to put money in people's hands as quickly as humanly possible so that they can address the pressures that they have because of job loss or the like of what's happening with our economy because of COVID-19. So these are a number of measures that have put in place. On the other side, we would rather is businesses be able to keep their employees. So we have also provided for businesses, and this when I say businesses,
sorry,
small businesses.
I just wanted to make a big announcement.
So, sure.
Just about the viewers that we are going to speak in Arabic. رجاء من كل المشاهدين مشاركة البث مع أكثر على صفحاتكم. رجاء من كل المشاهدين مشاركة البث الآن على صفحاتكم ليستفيد أكبر عدد من المتابعين أو من الناس المحتاجين لهذه البرامج. هاي رقم واحد. رقم اثنين بعد المشاركة هيكون في ترجمة عربية لكل ما حدث وكل ما تحدثنا به. هيكون في conversation يعني محادثة بيني وبين الدكتور جمال عم نحكي فيها بالتفاصيل شو اللي حكاه بيتر فونسيكا. فما حدا يزهق، ما حدا يمشي، اللي بيحكي عربي اللي مش فاهمان علينا انجليزي يضل موجود، حيكون في ترجمة كاملة لكل الموضوع بعد ما نخلص. خليكم معنا. Go ahead, Mr. Peter.
Yeah, so Sam, and for all of your viewers and all those that will see this at a later time, what I do implore people to receive many of the benefits, like the Canada Child Benefit in terms of what they receive, or the GST tax credit, etc. I ask that you do your taxes as soon as possible, because by doing your taxes, you will have more opportunity to be able to receive those monies quicker. Now, what we have done also, because of all that is going on, we have moved the date in terms of when you have to do your filing for taxes now to June 1st, to June 1st. So we've moved it a month forward, so to give people more time. But people that are going to be receiving money under these programs, it's better to you do your taxes sooner rather than later because you're able to receive some of these funds much quicker. So just so people are aware of that.
So and, if you don't, yes. if you don't do your taxes, it will be calculated on your old taxes, you mean?
Yeah, so your circumstances change. Plus, many people that would be maybe some of our more vulnerable citizens will be receiving a tax rebate. So they will be getting money back by doing their taxes. So the quicker that you do your taxes and put your taxes in, the sooner you will be getting those rebates back right away from the government. So you would not want to wait on that. So you want to make sure that you have your taxes done as soon as possible, because that will mean more money in your pocket a lot sooner. So I do ask people to be able to do that. Maybe that's something that you can do from home, online, etc., while you are in isolation or going through this experience. Now, on the other hand, we have so many small, medium. We have large businesses also in Canada, but our small and medium businesses are really the backbone of our economy. Yep. We're talking the mom and pop shops. We're talking about the restaurants. You know, they do so much hard work, and they are hard businesses to manage and to run just under normal circumstances. But when something like this happens, like a real tsunami hits them, we need to come in and help those businesses. So what we have done is there is a 10% subsidy for businesses in terms of a work subsidy that would pay 10% of your workers' wages. At this time, this is what we have put forward for those businesses. We've also worked through the Business Development Bank of Canada and our other banks to find ways that they can defer some of their payments. This also works not only for businesses, but it also works for individuals that have homes. Many of us have mortgages, and those mortgages will weigh very heavily on people once, if there is no income coming in or little income coming in before compared to what there was before. So the ability to be able to defer and get through some of this difficult period is something that we are working with our biggest banks, as well as with the Business Development Bank of Canada.
Okay, Peter, I have a question in here that raised and there been a lot of talk about it. Deferred, a lot of people, even in the English, don't really get the point on deferred payments. So, it just have to put things in the right perspective. Nobody is going to pay a mortgage payment. This is billions of dollars. Deferred mean delayed. So you don't pay it right now, you pay it later. But it is easier on you and it has no interest. So it is like someone telling you, you owe me this money, but I don't want this money from you now. Pay me later. But that means if you have 10 years, it's going to be 10 years and a month, 10 years and 2, 3 months, whatever it is. But that's actually relaxing because you don't have to be worried right now. You're not under pressure and you will have no interest on top of that money. It will be paid later. The same term, they're not going to come back until you pay me 2 months together. No, it's going to be deferred to the end of the payment. Am I right in there?
Well, I think that you should have that conversation with your financial institution. So you should, if you have a mortgage with CIBC or TD or BMO or RBC or any of the banks or whoever your lender is, to see how you would defer your payments and when the payback would happen. And it'll be different, I think, for everybody in terms of how they decide to do that. But what I can say is that deferral is, and you're right, it will give people some breathing room to be able to address some of the bigger pressures that they have on themselves right now. It may make the difference in between, like, you know, what are they, the stress that they have of taking care of a loved one or having to go to work in a very difficult situation. So that person can make that decision a lot easier to address family needs at this time. So it is the right thing to do by supporting Canadians. Canadians have worked very hard. They've invested a lot to buy their homes, and we want to make sure that they're able to stay in their homes. This will all pass over a number of months, but during this time, we are taking these extraordinary measures.
Sam, there's a question about rent.
We're going to go back. Questions after we finish just what we have.
No, it's again deferral rent.
So Sam, I'll just like to tell you, like, you know, so what's been going on with the Member of Parliament's office? So at this time, as you can see right here, I'm working kind of from my home office. This is kind of my home office over here.
Awesome.
And my home office, so what... And the reason we do that is so we are also implementing those best practices. It still means that we take calls here at home. We're able to answer all the questions online for people. We are still receiving all of their information and their cases still continue. Many of the calls that myself and my colleagues right across the country have been receiving, of course, has been from Canadians that are abroad. They're in countries all over the world,
yep.
And they're looking to get back home.
Yeah.
Many of them have been repatriated. They have come home. You've probably heard the news.
I called your office for a couple, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So this has been kind of our focus has been really on the most immediate pressing needs where people are in really dire circumstances. And we need to address those needs of theirs. We're also fielding many calls, of course, from workers, from businesses, etc. So I'm glad that the package that was put forward, and let me say, that was the initial package. So the Prime Minister and the Minister of Finance have already said that was phase one, you know, and we have a lot of firepower within our arsenal to be able to implement further phases. And that what that will mean will be more supports for workers, for our economy, and to be able to also to keep people healthy and safe. So the way that it's being addressed is the way that only by listening to experts. So the decisions that you hear the Prime Minister or the Minister of Health or Minister of Finance make at the federal level, as well as provincially or mayors in cities, what I'm glad to hear is that in Canada, it has all been done based on science, best practices, the research that we have. And I know Dr. Jamal will like this because it is not something that we are doing anecdotally. It is something based on the numbers. So it is the best approach is to listen to the experts. And when this comes to the health side, but also with the economy, we are listening to the experts that are the leaders in business. So business leaders, chambers of commerce, and others have come to us, and they have put forward what are their top priorities and how best the government can help.
Okay, Peter, I'm going to take a short break here with Dr. Jamal, and let's do his question because it has to do actually with our topic in the core, and it is about rent. Go ahead, Dr. Jamal.
There's a questions about deferral of rent, how it could happen. There's a question of Dua Khairi. Can you ask?
Do you hear Dr. Jamal, Peter?
I cannot hear okay. Dr. Jamal.
So I'm going to ask the question. The question is from a lady named Dua Khairi who works in Toronto, and her question is about rent. So people who have mortgages, we understand they're going to defer their mortgage, but people who have this $2,200 payment a month for rent and they're not working and they're living paycheck to paycheck, they're living meet ends. How can they pay their payments if landlords are not banks? So if there is anything for landlords.
Yeah, so because it is under provincial jurisdiction, so here in Ontario, Premier Ford has said that nobody will be evicted at this time. And what I encourage renters and landlords and both to do is to reach out to each other and to, if somebody is in challenging times, of course, with help from the government, to be able to address and to bridge through this difficult time. But that's one of the reasons that federally what we are in charge of and what we were able to do is increase things like the child benefit, provide a new benefit for workers that weren't covered under employment insurance. Now they have the emergency care benefit or the emergency support benefit. Those are the benefits that will help in terms of bringing more funds into the house if someone has lost their job. But I understand that mean the rents are very high. But the best way to do this would be to reach out to the landlord and work this through with the landlord. The landlords may also have some opportunity to work with their financial institutions to see what can be done.
Yes.
I think there's a lot of unknowns at this time because this is new to all of us. But what I can tell you is I only hear goodwill and people working together to get through this this difficult time.
Definitely. So we'll talk further about this after we finish the discussion. We're keeping notes of everything we're talking. للمشاهدين العرب مثل ما حكينا مرة تاني احنا حنتابع بعد ما يخلص معنا بيتر فونسيكا وحنحكي معكم بالعربي عن كل شيء حكيناه وحنحكي عن موضوع الإيجار ونصائح بيتر فونسيكا عن الإيجار. طيب the next question will be is the money going to be deposited it deposited or is it going to be checks like it happened in the state? Peter?
Well, through the CRA, Sam, is you know, if someone has an account already, they already have access to direct deposit, and direct deposit is the fastest way to be able to get that money into people's hands because it goes right directly into their bank account. But there are instances where somebody does not have that ability. So that would be for those people that would not have that ability. Of course, they would have to get it through a check or another form. But through direct deposit is the best way for us to be able to get money into people's pockets as quickly as possible. We understand that time is of the essence now, and we don't want to delay time by mailing something out and cutting checks, etc. That takes more time.
Definitely.
The faster that we could get the money into the hands of workers, of businesses, etc., that is good for all of us. So that is what we want to see happen.
You're asking again about lockdown. Is there any lockdown?
We will have a discussion about that, Dr. Jamal, toward the end. Interactive jobs, Peter. Interactive jobs meaning a taxi driver, Uber driver, some of those people got very scared. They have kids, they have seniors at home, and they can't justify that to government. Should people like this who are very scared for their life stay home because they feel it is unfair to be on the road? So I got a lot of calls from Uber drivers, newcomers, people who drive Ubers, and they're saying, and there's also daycare providers, and those, they received an email from the ministry telling them, don't deal with children right now. So, you know, you can't bring 5-6 children to your home and sit down with them and then their parents coming over and stuff. Those would be more than 5 people, 10 people. So people who run daycares, and that's a lot of ladies and people who run daycares in Mississauga and Peel area, and Uber driver and taxi driver, what can they do at the moment? Which program do you see for fit them the best?
That's a great question, Sam. And I think we've discussed a number of programs, and I think all of them are somewhat applicable to a circumstance like that. So if you have already a daycare that's open, you can apply for some of the subsidies that are available for businesses. But also, on the other hand, for the workers, there's the emergency care benefit. Some of those workers may not fall into workers that are today were eligible for employment insurance, but now they will be employment insurance will be available to them through the emergency care benefit. So that would be the same also for Uber drivers. So a driver that is an Uber driver or somebody that feels that they should be in isolation, they can now apply for the emergency care benefit. As I said, up to $450 per week, $900 biweekly. That is a once ever that Canada's never done this before. It is really an extraordinary measure, but will allow all of these workers that are considered in the gig economy to be able to have those necessary funds. And Sam, just getting back to our conversation that we were having in terms of help for our residents, I was explaining many of the things that are available to them, to workers, et cetera, through the federal government. But there are many things that are being done provincially and also municipally. So I know there is a deferral program here in Mississauga right now of 3 months on your property tax. So for the next 3 months, they would not have to pay their property tax over the next 3 months, and then it would pick up again. So, and we're trying to bridge through this difficult time, and we don't know yet even if in 3 months or in 6 months or when we've moved some of these dates, if they may go on even longer, depending on what is happening on the ground health-wise. So Dr. Jamal would probably know more about that. But this is really hour by hour, things continue to change. But again, what people should feel good about is that all the decisions that are being made by officials, by elected representatives, are based on science. They are based on research. They are based on the numbers that are coming in, and also on the experiences that we've seen of what's happened in China, in South Korea, and also in difficult spots like Italy, as well as Spain. So we want to make sure that we can do the best we can here for Canadians. So hour by hour, day by day, and it feels like every day is a lifetime, things change quickly, and the government continues to adapt by listening to professionals in the healthcare field, in the fields of economy, social services, etc., to be able to attack this invisible enemy as best we can.
You say that right, bang on, invisible enemy. It is an enemy that's attacking the whole world altogether. And the whole world needs to stand together beside their colors, cultures, religion, politics, all that stay aside when it comes to humanity. So it is time for human to stand together and defeat this enemy. Peter, I know one hand doesn't clap, and I know there is above 338 members of parliament in the House. But if we give you something to take back with you, would you ask about it? Would you not consider it, but would you reach the message? So for small businesses, people don't think it is enough, the 10%, for one reason. A lot of them actually shut down the business and they stayed home. So they have no employee to pay. And their employees cannot be paid because they are very small business. It is a small convenience store with two people or a small dry cleaning store. And they shut down because they're very scared to take other people's clothes and walk. So they shut down. And those two people who work there are sitting home. So the guy can't even afford paying his rent, never mind paying his employee. So a person like this, there is nothing for him because there is no EI. He's self-employed. And there, and the 10% is not beneficial. Or the daycare lady who worked alone in there and she shut down the daycare. So if you could take that back, there is tens of thousands in over each region who work in those fields, either very small businesses or daycare providers. So if this is something you could ask about, we would really appreciate it. So this way, we didn't, you know, we put a mission for Peter to take with him. We didn't leave him alone, okay? So
that you know, that's a great comment that you put forward, and we have heard that. So that is something that the finance minister has been hearing loud and clear. Now, those individuals that you mentioned, they are eligible for the emergency care benefit. No,
we didn't talk about that. Yeah,
that's right. So they should apply for that. Like I said, this is all new, but they should apply for that. The other thing that your viewers should know is that MPs every day, I will be on a call in an hour and a half from now, and there are calls throughout the day where MPs from across the country get on the calls with the experts, and we are able to pose those questions, put those questions forward, and tell about the challenges that we hear that are happening in our parts of the country. So thank you for that. And so that everybody is aware of that.
It is a new info for me and all the followers and audience that because they think MPs only go to the Parliament House, they do their turn and they talk there. Actually, that's a new info for me and all the audience that MPs have committees and subcommittees and they do have phone calls among each other and they do talk and they do negotiate what's happening in each constituent. And then they bring the stuff forward. So your voice is actually being heard. It is not just like, okay, you send a message and it will not be heard. Definitely your voice is being heard.
So as I said, daily briefings every day, including weekends, like today, Sunday, every day are happening. And this is for all MPs right across the country. And MPs are able to bring forward cases that they have that are difficult on the ground in their areas, as well as put forward questions and priorities, like you just said, for a business that they would like to see implemented, be it in this phase or in phase two. Also, you probably heard today on the news that some 30 some odd MPs are being called back to Parliament for Tuesday. And the reason that people will hear that, and they're all pretty much the people that can drive into Parliament, and this is to pass legislation. And because we have all party support on the legislation, understanding that we need these emergency funds, that will be passed on Tuesday straight to the Senate. And we understand, again, that will be passed in one day. This never happens. So we all understand this is a warlike effort that we are in. And we are all in this together. And we have put partisanship aside. And we want to make sure that the monies can get to the people as quickly as possible.
And the people really appreciate that from all of you. We are at 70% almost. So number seven, how do we apply? And I believe people went online, they opened their bank account, they opened their CRA account, and I did that. And they checked, and there is no messages yet. And I said, in me following the news and being like in the community head and, you know, listening to so many people, I said, you know what, the government didn't have time yet. And that's why I heard you and a couple other MPs saying April. And then I put that dots together and I was like, it is definitely not now. It will happen within the next couple or 3 or 4 weeks, right?
Yeah, you're correct, Sam. So because I'm glad you went through your CRA account. And so we have said in the first week of April is when it will be brought forward. Also, what's happening on Tuesday in Parliament will be passing legislation to be able to deliver that money. Mm. So unless we do that so that money can flow. But this is a new program, never been done before. This is, like I said, this is historic for Canada. It has never been done. Now, we want to ensure we are taking all Canadians on good faith. That, you know, people that, like you said, that have a dry cleaning business, individuals that take care of, you know, kids, have a daycare, whatever, so they can put forward their claim and get some money from government, which in the past, if they were not eligible for employment insurance, they wouldn't be able to do that.
Definitely. Now, that being said, there is a question, but we will answer it after, which is about how do I apply for business? The same thing. It's all going to go for small business. It's going to go through CRA. It is foggy light right now. There is something very important to mention in here. Canada is a democratic system, and it works on legislation. So that means we will announce that in Arabic also, Dr. Jamal. It works on passing bills and passing legislation. Nobody can stand there like in some other countries and say, listen, I'm going to do this and it's done. No, it doesn't work this way. Am I right, Peter? So it must be passed even if it is an emergency. People have there's a minimum number of MPs that have to gather and pass a legislation. Am I right?
You're correct, Sam. We do live in a democracy. We listen to each other, and but we all understand that we're doing this all together. To be able to take care of Canadians. So in an extraordinary way, again, parliamentarians, the minimum amount that you can bring in, which I believe is just over 30, I think it's 32, that will be coming into to Ottawa. It's proportional to the amount of members of parliament that you have or the percentage of members that you have right now in parliament. So I think we're going to have about 14 liberals will be part of that. And then so many conservatives, NDP, Bloc, etc. So, but everybody's on the same page. We want to pass this as quickly as possible. There will be some debate as part of the procedures. I think it's about 4 hours or so of debate. And then once passed on Tuesday, that will go into the Senate. And my understanding is the Senate will pass it expeditiously. So within a day, and it will receive royal assent, and those monies can start to go out to people.
Awesome. I'll go through that with people after explaining to them. So the next question, and we're almost there, is about do I have to call each of the services to defer or to delay the payment, such as OSAP? OSAP, we all heard about, not only OSAP, and let's say, because OSAP is Ontario, so let's talk about student loans. Student loans have been deferred, and they're not going to call you. They will not bother you right now. Do I need to call them and tell them, like, well, I know I'm sitting home, but I don't want an extra work. So do I need to call OSAP or whatever student loan and tell them, listen, I want to defer. Do I need the bank? I know I need to call the bank. But the rest of them, do I need to call everything else and ask them for a break or deferral?
Well, I can't go program by program, but we did say 6 months that that we would defer the with the student loans. So that will, and that is on top of something that we had already passed, that even once somebody is graduated, just say they're finished this year, that they will not have to pay that loan back and no interest will be accrued until they get a job and they're making at least $35,000. So this will give people quite a bit of time in terms of being able to absorb this challenge and to then get on to paying their loans. As far as do you have to call or not, Sam, I'd like to give you the exact answer, so I don't want to say. I would think not, though, because it's system-wide. It is for everybody, but I don't want to, individuals probably should check, but I think online in a blog, I'm sure people will all know very quickly.
Very true. So what about mortgages and credit payments? That you'll have to call your bank and your creditors, whatever credit you own. If you own credit card, that has nothing to do with government. You need to call your bank for credit. If you own like for a car, you need to call
now, the banks. What you should say to your bank, if your bank, you know, hopefully your bank will work with you and be understanding. But the government of Canada has put $300 billion in liquidity through the banks. So there's a lot of money there, a lot of money that banks can use to be able to help their customers through this difficult time. So, but I do request that the customers contact their bank, their institution that they have their loan with.
Awesome. So utilities, the final thing in here I have is, and then we're going to talk about one more thing, mortgage payment. Utilities, if there is anything about utilities, I know electricity, gas, and water is regional, but overall people will ask their government. So utilities, anything you did for utilities?
You know, I'm not sure on the utilities side as far as what the provincial or municipal governments are doing. I can tell you on the municipal side, as I said, they've deferred the tax payments on property tax for 3 months.
Yeah.
They have, if you want to use public transit, like here in Mississauga, it is now free to use public transit. And you don't have to go through the front, you go through the back door, et cetera, for social distancing. So the city has brought forward a number of measures also to help with its citizens and being able to get over this time. So that's happening at, like I said, it's all of government. When I say that, I don't mean federal. I mean federal, provincial, municipal governments, everybody working together, understanding, too, that there's a lot of strain on our system. Many of our not-for-profits, like your organization and others, are being challenged because they run on volunteers, and many of those volunteers are seniors or they're self-isolating. They're people that are taking care of themselves and their family. So there's a lot of strain out there. So everybody is a new normal, and we're all coming together and finding ways to address this. But what I can say is that all politicians, representatives of the people, are here to listen and implement the best practices, the best things that we think can help the most people through this time. And I'm sure Dr. Jamal will talk about that in terms of what we're doing with our healthcare resources. I know that personal protective equipment is a hot topic right now. I understand that Canada is doing quite a good job in terms of having that personal protective equipment, but in that same vein, it may not be enough. So we're working with businesses to be able to retool. And I want to thank those many businesses that are out there because they're able to retool. And we have distilleries that used to make alcohol. Now they're making sanitizers. You know, they're making so that this is a great thing. Sam, I just want to thank all of your viewers. Thank you.
Did you see everybody on the Facebook talking about this? So what happened, and this will be the final thing. I saved it to the end. So today in somewhere in a province around Canada, provincial parks, and it is a little bit warmer area in Canada. Provincial park, beaches were full, a lot of people are out. It is like nothing happening. And unfortunately, there is a name for those. I know as an MP, you can't insult anyone. And I don't like to insult as a public worker, anyone. But there's like a corona idiotic, or there's so many names that been out there right now. They made terminologies on Google for them. Like, come on, What does it take you to stay home? What does it take you to keep social distance between you and other? Going to a park and gathering all together, 20, 30 people, going to the beaches, come on. People, you're hurting me, you're hurting my family, you're hurting my kids, you're hurting my mom and dad who are in their 70s. Does it take the government to put their army down like it happened in other countries? Just like what happened today in New York, I believe. Does it take that for us to stay home? Come on.
Yeah, you're right, Sam. People are, if someone is doing that, they're not being, they're being irresponsible. They're hurting themselves and they're hurting those around them, so their community. So we have seen that some provinces, Nova Scotia today has implemented a new rule where you can have a gathering of more than five people. They've also, you know, the premier there came out pretty strongly that that he was seeing some of this activity. I know Mayor Crombie has also done the same on social media in terms of seeing many people at the park, all playing with each other, etc. People do have to understand, we will continue to repeat that, you know, how serious this is, and for people to implement those the best practices of social distancing, washing their hands, etc., and isolation. So this is what we will continue to do. We hope that through the measures, through the municipalities and the provinces, etc., and by hearing people like yourself, Dr. Jamal, and others, that they will adhere and adhere to these warnings. But, you know,
Peter,
it may take that they'll have to get fined and we will have to take some stronger action.
Peter, what happened in the past 48 hours, a petition has started on change.org, and the petition is for Canadians only, and it has within 48 hours collected about 5,000 signatures from Canadians asking strongly for a lockdown, because we understand every country has responsible people, has people who have, they are full of thoughtful of others, but there is also in every country around the world, people who doesn't listen, people who doesn't understand, and people who are irresponsible in every single country around the world. So for that, we don't want to hurt Canada. We don't want to see ourselves where Italy or Spain are today, where the U.S. is going right now. They are in the third, I think, category. We are number 16. I was looking number 16 and worse, how bad it is. I monitor the map, the world map on World Health Organization for the past 3 weeks. We were number 55. Last week, we were number 22. Today, we are number 15 or 16. We are going exactly, I don't want to scare people, but science doesn't know lies. Science is numbers. And through the numbers and the map of the World Health Organization, we are level. We are shoulder to shoulder with Italy on the path they were going. And if people don't wake up, if we don't take very strong leadership, things will not be very, the sky will not be blue very soon. And I'm optimistic. I'm very optimistic. And I bring smile to my viewers, but at the same time, when it is reality, and if it takes me to scare them a little bit to stay home, I will do that. Peter, the message, if you could take that message from the people who started the shut down Canada, please, for our own safety, so we don't follow other countries. If you could take that message to the Prime Minister or to anybody in there, we would really appreciate it. It's already within 48 hours sitting at 5,000 people from all Canadian, all across Canada.
Yeah, thank you. I will, Sam. You know, because there are people that are taking big risks. I'm not talking about the people that are making irresponsible decisions. I'm talking about the people that are putting themselves on the line, our healthcare workers, our people working in grocery stores, people that have to provide essential services, are doing all of this, you know, for our betterment. And then some people are being irresponsible and just breaking the rules and not doing what they should be doing. And they know what they should be doing because the message is loud and clear and is coming from everybody. And it is a very consistent message to do things like isolation, as well as keeping your hands clean and social distancing. So all of this is very important, but we cannot repeat it enough. Continue to repeat it and let people know. And also, people should be shamed into not doing these things.
Definitely. Final thing, Peter, before I thank you, the airports, I know people want to understand, is airports federal jurisdiction or provincial jurisdiction or municipal jurisdiction, or is it a shared custody among all of you? Shared custody. So,
it's a great question. It is federal. The airports are under federal jurisdiction. Sometimes it changes a little bit depending on labor and the workers that are there, but they are under federal jurisdiction.
Peter, I am. This channel is running on daily basis right now because of the emergency. We are really bringing your message to the public. We're really trying as much to waken the public, to bring messages out and tell them how to wash their hands. The doctor talked a lot on this channel and his channel about hygiene, washing, distance, all this important stuff in this hard time. But the airport, we've seen a lot of movies documented through even news hubs from Toronto. I don't want to mention names of news hubs, where they went there and they recorded how the only thing they give to new to anybody arriving is a form. Do you have Corona? And lots of people went out and they said, yes, we have Corona, and we didn't say it. So, like, what's happening? Like, I seen videos from Karachi, from all over the world, where there is doctors, there is people who are wearing the full gear, and they would meet those people coming in the airplane. They will make sure to ask them to take their fever, to make sure they are. And you know, Peter, in the end of the day, I represent the people, and I know the same with you, and I'll bring the message because I don't want them to come back to me and say, Sam, why you didn't ask? You don't deserve to be talking to Peter. So I really want to bring what they say to you, Peter. So people are very worried about the airport. And there isn't much being happening at the airport. Any idea in there?
So what I can say, Sam, is that the airport also is, the airports are changing hour by hour, day to day. And so now we are triaging. So there are only four airports in Canada that are accepting international flights to come in: Vancouver, Calgary, Toronto, Montreal. And then from there, it'd be domestic flights from there. And within those airports, depending on where some of those flights were coming from, they did take different levels of care in terms of their security and being able to provide the information that people needed in terms of awareness for isolation, where they were coming from, if they were showing any kind of symptoms, et cetera. So that information is being provided. But we did hear from, and I'll be honest, from many MPs from across the country, where people thought that things were still falling through the cracks and not working as well as they should at the airports. And I think that's a different story today. But I think a week ago, things weren't as good as they could have been.
I hope so. Peter, I cannot thank you enough for taking this important time of your day, giving us an hour. And I would encourage you again, if there is any new news and you want to bring it to the public, please, you have my number, connect with me, let me know, give us some good news. If there is something new, if our scientists have come up with a cure for this, I think Dr. Jamal will be the first to tell us this news.
Well, I'll be good. Dr. Jamal will talk about that. You know, what we did here is that I know that Canada's invested. We've put another $300 million into finding a cure for this. And we're working in a global forum to be able to do that. So there's testing going on, and Canada is a big part of that, so that when the vaccine is available, Canadians will be amongst the first to be able to receive that vaccine and deploy that vaccine across the country.
Thank you, Peter. Peter, I want to wish you a safe time with your family. Please, I'm going to advise you just like you advise us. Please stay safe, stay close, and I hope to see you in good times, just like the old days. Thank you very much for being with us today, Peter.
Thanks, Sam. Thanks, Sav Canada. Stay healthy, stay safe.
Thank you.
Thank you, Peter.
Thank you.
جاء دورنا
دكتور. طيب. انا بدي اعبي كافي وارجع.
روح انا ببدا احكي مع الناس. يلا
للمشاهدين، انا اخذ بريك دقيقه واحده، اعبي فنجان القهوه تبعي وارجع لكم. معكم دكتور جمال، حيبلش معكم.
يلا. طبعا اول شيء تكلم بيتر عن ما تقوم به الحكومه من اجراءات في محاربه هذا الفيروس. الفيروس هذا زي ما حكى أنه هو فيروس عالمي وليس فقط في كندا، وعلينا جميعا أن نقوم بأخذ الحيطة والحذر، وليس فقط الحكومة بل الشعب. وشكر طبعا كل من يقوم بعزل نفسه، غسل يديه، مساعدة الآخرين، والاستماع لتوجيهات مسؤولين الصحة. وهذا إشي مهم جدا، ونرجع بنكرر عليه أنه المسؤولية الشخصية اللي بتقوم فيها أنت اليوم هي مسؤولية ليست فقط لحمايتك شخصيا، بل لحماية أفراد عائلتك والمجتمع كامل، ويمكن البشرية كلها. فاللي أنت بتقوم فيه وأنا بقوم فيه هذا إشي يعني فوق العادة، ومسؤولية ليست بالبسيطة، ولكن أنت كذلك بهذه الطريقة تحمي البشرية كاملة. فأنت كون proud من نفسك، كون مفتخر بما تقوم به، وعلم أبنائك أنه هذا الشيء اللي إن شاء الله رب العالمين خلال أسبوعين ثلاث راح ينتهي، راح نرجع للشيء الطبيعي. طبعا بدأ يحكي عن موضوع الاقتصاد. الحكومة جهزت حوالي 82 مليار دولار أو بليون دولار لمساعدة الاقتصاد الكندي. 27 مليار راح يكونوا للعمال والعوائل الفاميليز اللي تأثروا بهذا الموضوع، هنحكي عنهم هلا. 55 مليار للبزنسز والتجار، و300 مليار هذول إضافية حطوهم في البنوك عشان يزودوا سيولة البنوك ويصير عندهم مبالغ يقدروا يستخدموها في استكمال إجراءاتهم. طبعاً بالنسبة للعمال حكى في شغلتين مهمات. الأولى هي اسمها EI اللي هي Employment Insurance، بما معناه أنه إذا واحد فقد عمله بسبب أي سبب بشكل عام بيقدر يقدم على شغلة في كندا اسمها Employment Insurance. كانت زمان لازم يقدم بعد أسبوع من فقدان العمل، الآن ما في داعي، ممكن يقدم عليها مباشرة. الشغلة الجديدة إنه العمال الغير مؤهلين، يعني ما عندهم عدد ساعات معين أو ما عندهم full time، الآن مؤهلين يحصلوا على شغلة اسمها Emergency Care Benefits، عبارة عن 900 دولار كل شهرين، كل أسبوعين، سوري، 900 دولار كل أسبوعين، 450 دولار بالأسبوع، بتقدموا عليها عن طريق الـ CRA account. الـ CRA account بتبدأ التقديم في بداية أبريل إن شاء الله. فاللي مستعجل الآن مش راح تكون موجودة، راح إن شاء الله تبدأ مع أبريل، وبتنزل خلال كل أسبوعين. وأول ما تتقدم إلها بتعمل زي ديكلاريشن إنك أنت متأثر من موضوع الكورونا وجالس في بيتك، أو عم ترعى شخص، أو عامل عندك كارانتين، وكل أسبوعين بتكرر هذا الديكلاريشن إنك لازم عشان تقدر تستفيد من المبالغ اللي بعدها. في راح ينزل من 300 ل 550 دولار للعائلة مع لدعم الأطفال، طبعا بيعتمد على الدخل في السنة الماضية أو السنة هاي حسب التاكس اللي انت مقدمه أو الضرائب. الجي اس تي للعوائل اللي دخلها أقل من 44 ألف دولار بياخده من 400 ل 600 دولار مرة واحدة، راح تنزل هذه برضو على حسابك عن طريق السي ار اي لما تقدم للضريبة. طبعا هو عمل نصيحة انه جميع الناس اللي بتقدر تقدم الان للضرائب او التاكس تقدم، مع انه التاكس كان مفترض انه يكون في 30/4 ديدلاين، يعني نهاية التقديم لازم يكون قبل 30/4. قدمت الحكومة شهر كامل، والان نهاية التقديم راح يكون 1/6 واحد حزيران. البيزنسز بيقدروا ياخذوا 10% بالمئة من دفعات الموظفين اذا ضلوا لسه ماشيين، زي مثلا الجروسري ستورز والفارماسيز اذا ضل عندهم موظفين. اللي ما عندهم موظفين، سأل سام عن الموضوع، حكى انه هدول بيقدروا يقدموا على الامبلويمنت انشورنس او الامرجنسي فاند. طبعا البنوك سأل سؤال مهم جدا، خاصة اللي ماخذ لون من البنك أو قرض من البنك، كيف يقدر يسوي؟ طبعا في تواصل مع البنوك، ومعظم البنوك الآن عم بتحاول إنها تساعد الكنديين عشان يأجلوا الدفعات بدون فوائد. أجين بنحكي كلمة يؤجلوا الدفعات بدون فوائد وتأجيل وليس إلغاء الدفعات. لازم طبعا نصح بيتر إنه لازم تتواصل مباشرة مع البنك تبعك أو اللندر تبعك اللي أنت ماخذ منه قرض عشان تقدر تتوصل لنتيجة وتعرف كيف راح تدفع هاي الأمور والإجراءات المناسبة تدفعها. طبعا معظم النواب حكى إنهم الآن بيشتغلوا من البيت، فإذا في عندك أي سؤال أي استفسار ممكن ترسل إيميل أو تتواصل مع مكتبهم وهم موجودين في البيت، التلفون محول على البيت فراح يردوا عليك قدر المستطاع. كتير كانت أسئلة حكى إجتهم عن طريق الكنديين اللي هم خارج كندا كيف بدهم يرجعوا، والحكومة عم تحاول تعمل إجراءات لمساعدة هؤلاء الأشخاص للعودة إلى كندا، ولأنهم بتعرفوا إحنا الحدود الكندية تقريبا أغلقت للطيران إلا في الحالات النادرة وفقط للكنديين انهم يرجعوا. والان سمعت انه كندا، طبعا هذه اضافه من عندي، انا سمعت انه كندا سمحت للطلاب والغير كنديين ومعهم ورك بيرميت انهم يرجعوا على كندا. طبعا اول حزمه من المساعدات ممكن الحكومة تقدم مساعدات أخرى أو حزمة أخرى، زي ما حكى رئيس الوزراء جاستن ترودو أنه هاي 82 مليار هي فقط الحزمة الأولى وإن شاء الله ما نحتاج غيرها، لأنه طبعا هاي كمية مبلغ كبير وتنتهي الأزمة قريبا، لكن ما حد عارف إمتى الأزمة حتنتهي، ممكن تأخذ أسبوع شهر شهرين ثلاث أربعة ست أشهر، كل هذا بيعتمد على تجاوبنا نحن كمواطنين مع الإجراءات المطلوبة. طبعا برضو أكد بيتر أنه كندا بتأخذ المعلومات والقرارات حسب العلم والعلماء والأطباء والاقتصاديين، وتتعلم أيضا من خبرات الآخرين من دول أخرى، وهذا شيء مهم جدا في اتخاذ القرار. يعني حكى أنه القرارات بتكون دائما مدروسة.
القرارات من عند أم حسين وأم فتحي وأم توفيق
ما في لا. طيب بالنسبة للإيجارات، سألنا بيتر عن الموضوع، حكى إنه الإيجار بشكل عام هي شيء يرجع تحت حكومة المقاطعة، بس خليني أشرح هذا الموضوع شوي، لأنه زي ما حكينا إحنا اللي ما بيعرف فيه بكندا ثلاث حكومات أو الحكومات الرئيسية اللي هي حكومة المدينة، حكومة المقاطعة والحكومة الفيدرالية، كل واحدة بتعتني بأمور، فالإيجارات هي تابعة للبروفينشال. ولكن داغ فورد في أنتاريو حكى إنه طبعا هذا اللي ساكنين في مقاطعة أنتاريو إنه لن يخرج أحد من منزله، فصاحب البيت ليس له حق إنه يطردك من المنزل، بس بالأفضل تتواصل مع المالك تبع البيت إنك تحكي معه يعني فيس تو فيس، إنه أو مش فيس تو فيس، عن طريق التلفون أو عن طريق السوشيال ميديا.
ما بعرف إذا أنت، لأنه متسلسل النقاط وراء بعض، بس إذا بتسمح لي مشان نناقش بعض المواضيع مع بعض. موضوع الإيجار بالعادي، إذا صاحب الملك، بما أني بشتغل بإدارة مكتب قانوني ومكتب محاماة مع محامين عندي في مساقة، فكتير بيمر علينا هذا الموضوع اللي هو الترايبونيال تبع الرنت ترايبونيال والمحاكم الإيجار وكذا. الموضوع مش سهل بالعادي، ما في انه اللاندلورد يجي هيك ويرشق واحد برا، لازم يكون عنده عطيه نوتس 30 يوم، وبعد ال 30 يوم بده يقدم على الترايبونيال الا اذا في جريمه او في شيء مشكله كبيره، وبعد ال 30 يوم بياخذ الموضوع تقريبا 90 يوم ليقدر انه يجيب لك شرطه او يعمل لك ايفاكيويت برا البيت. فما بالكم في هاي الحاله اللي احنا فيها. لكن احنا اكيد مثل ما تفضل دكتور جمال ومثل ما حكى بيتر فونسيكا، نحن ما بدنا الموضوع يوصل انه يصير في عناد او يصير في مشاكل بينك وبين صاحب البيت، لانه صاحب البيت هذا كمان متضرر مثلك، وبعدين انتوا حتتعايشوا مع بعض في الايام القادمه اللي هي حتكون ايام جميله ان شاء الله وينتهي هذا الوباء علينا. فبهالحاله هاي انت ما بدك تتقاتل مع صاحب البيت، فالافضل اذا انت مش قادر تدفع الايجار او مش قادر تدفع الايجار بشكل كامل، يعني ممكن انت هلا اخف المبالغ اللي بتجيك والايجار 2000 بس قادر تعطي 1500 من التشايلد تاكس بنفيت والاشياء اللي بتجيك، اتصل بصاحب البيت، لقيته ما لقيته اترك له مسج، احكي معه حيرجع لك لانه الموضوع مهم، احكي معه واشرح له الموقف وقول له انا مش قادر ادفع المبلغ كامل، وهو انا متاكد بنسبه 100% اذا ما رضي خليه يتصل علي، يعطيني رقمه وانا بتصل لك فيه، ما عندي مشكله اساعد الناس. الدكتور جمال بيساعدكم في اوتاوا. عرفت دكتور.
طيب
لاندلورد بشكل عام حيكونوا متساعدين معاكم، واذا في ديفيرال ياخر لك ال $500 قسط له اياها في دفعات قادمه حيعملها، لكن صاحب البيت ما حيشيل لك ايجارات ببلاش لانه هو عليه دفعات والدفعات تبعه ما عم تلتغي عم تتاجل، فهو كمان بده يدفع، فممكن ياجل لك بس ما ممكن يشيل لك. فهي مهم انه يعني نفهمها مع بعض ويفهموها.
هون سام يعني انا بدي احكي بس برضو عتب على بعض الجرائد العربيه اللي ترجمت خطاب جاستن ترودو الاول، كان انه الحكومه الكنديه ستدفع الايجارات عن المواطنين، وشفناها بكثير جرائد وحتى انتشرت في السوشيال ميديا، وجاستن ترودو اصلا ما حكى وي ويل نوت ميك كنديان وري اباوت ذا رنت، فكان الموضوع يعني الترجمه كانت شويه بتختلف. anyway ان شاء الله يصلحوا هذا الموضوع، يعني هذا عتب من الحبيب للحبيب.
هو كان فقط فكرة ترجمة، المشكلة كانت في الترجمة. ممكن كلمة ديفيرال وفي كلمات احيانا كبيرة بتمر حتى علينا احنا اللي قاعدين في كندا من سنين، فلازم حالي الواحد عن جد يدقق في هذه الكلمات ويفحصها مزبوط، مشان ما لانه المستمعين في اخر اليوم اجاهم هوب وامل انه احنا ما حندفع، لا حيندفع كل شيء حيدفع، الشيء الوحيد حيتاخر مشان تخفيف عنكم. والحكومه عم تزيد لكم دفعات في الوقت الحالي خلال الاشهر القادمه مشان تساعدكم بالمصيبه او بالمشكله اللي احنا فيها.
طيب المبالغ، حكى كمان المبالغ اللي ستدفع من السي ار اي اللي هي تشايلد بنفيتس، او اذا عندك اي شيء، اذا انت مشترك في الدايركت ديبوزيت يعني انها تنزل لك على البنك مباشره، ستدفع بهاي الطريقه لانها اسرع طريقه واسهل طريقه بالنسبه للحكومه، وغير ذلك سترسل لك على تشيك، وهذا طبعا حياخذ وقت اكيد، فالافضل انك تكون مشترك عن طريق الدايركت ديبوزيت، واذا ما بتعرف اي واحد بيساعدك من المحاسبين اللي حيسوي لك التاكس. بالنسبة سؤال كان نسأل عن طريق الأخسام، عن اللي هم الناس اللي بيشتغلوا في أوبر أو في تكاسي أو في دي كير، هدول اللي يعني ما هم لا أصحاب بيزنس أو
بالنص معلقين يعني،
لا هم بيشتغلوا فول تايم وكل الموضوع يعني حسب ما بيشتغل، فقال نعم هم بيقدروا إذا عنده داي كير وبيقدر يتقدم على بيزنس، أو عنده بيزنس داي كير بيقدر يتقدم إنه يأخذ بنفيتس تبعون البيزنس، إذا لا وعنده باي تشيك بيقدر يتقدم على الإي آي، وإذا لا الإي آي الإمبلويمنت إنشورنس، وإذا لا بيقدر يتقدم على الإميرجنسي كير بنفيتس اللي هي $900 بالأسبوعين. بالنسبة لموضوع
كتير مهم شرح القصة، لما نحن ما حنقولكم مثل بالهجرة بنقول للواحد قصتك هي أهم إشي في الهجرة دكتور، لو قصتك مش مضبوطة وكاملة وحقيقية ما حتنجح قضية الهجرة تبعك. نفس الشيء هون، فكر منيح واحكي الحقيقة، شو هي قصتك إنك أنت عم تقدم على الامرجنسي كير؟ يعني إذا إجيت وقصتك مش متراكبة الأوفيسر ما حيعطيك لأنه هي مش لكل شخص، فبدها تكون قصتك كاملة وحقيقية ومضبوطة مشان تقدر تاخذ الامرجنسي كير. تفضل دكتور.
بالنسبة لتأجيل ضرائب المنازل اللي هي property taxes، هاي حكى انها طبعا تابعة لكل مدينة، كل مدينة بتأخذ الإجراءات، في بعض المدن أخذت إجراءات انها تأجلها 3 أشهر، وسينظر في الموضوع مثل مدينة ميسيساغا وتورونتو زي ما فهمت، لكن again هذا بيعتمد على المدينة اللي انت ساكن فيها، لازم تسأل السيتي كونسلر إذا بدك أو تطلع على موقع المدينة، أكيد راح يكون كل المعلومات موجودة.
تمام، أنا هحكي بالنسبة لميسيساغا وبرامتون لأنه وصلني الإيميلز منهم. فgood news للساكنين في ميسيساغا وبرامتون، مير بوني كرامبي والكونسل اللي معاها ومير باتريك براون والكونسل اللي معاها طلعوا قرار بتأخير الضرائب اللي هي تبع البروبرتي تاكسز. البروبرتي تاكسز يعني انه بتتاخر البروبرتي تاكسز تبعكم، فما بتصير تنسحب مع المورجج لانه المورجج بيكون برينسيبل بالعادي، وفي ناس بتحط، مش كل الناس، في ناس بتحط التاكسز تبعها مع المورجج، فبيطلع مبلغ واحد من البنك. هاي شغله عملوها من شي 5 سنين مشان يسهلوا العمليه، فالان بيصير يطلع مبلغ اقل منكم لانه البروبرتي تاكس ما عاد بدها اياها مؤقتا حكومه المدينه، فهذا خبر كويس. الخبر الثاني اللي عم ينحكى فيه هلا في ميسيساغا وبرامتون اللي هو اليوتيليتيز اللي هي الكهرباء والمي والغاز، تاخير هذه الاشياء هتابع اكثر وحرجع لكم في هذا الموضوع خلال الايام القادمه ان شاء الله مع رسائل مباشره من السيتي هول. نتابع دكتور.
طيب حكى انه في بدايه ابريل ان شاء الله حيجتمعوا النواب، حيجتمع جزء من النواب وليس كلهم في البرلمان عشان يصوتوا على هذا القانون ويمشوه خلال يوم واحد، وهي اول مره بتصير في تاريخ كندا انه يمشي قانون ويتوقع من السنتس ومن الحاكم العام في كندا عشان يقدروا يبداوا في تنفيذ هذه الحزمه من المساعدات، ومعظم البرلمانيين متفقين عليها، فإن شاء الله حتمر يعني. بس تعرفوا إحنا دولة برلمانية فلازم يمر عن طريق البرلمان عشان يقدروا يستخدموا هذه legally أو قانونيا أمام الشعب. طبعا هل أتصل مع الكل؟ أوكي. بالنسبة في سؤال كان كيف أنا بقدر أشتغل أو أخلص كل أموري هاي، هل لازم أتصل مع كل من واحد من مقدمين هذه الخدمات؟ للأسف يس، لأنه زي ما بتفهموا أنه مقدم الخدمات بعضهم يختلف عن الآخر، فالحكومة تختلف عن البنك والبنك يختلف عن الحكومة الفيدرالية والسيتي والأوتوليتيز وكل يعني كل واحد بدك يعني بدك الله يعينك مدام قاعدين حط لك نص ساعة كل يوم. بالنسبة لتأجيل الأوساب برضو حكى عن موضوع الطلاب اللي بدفعوا اللي هم اللون اللي بياخذوه أو القرض الدراسي اللي بياخذوه من الحكومة. طبعا هذا بس لمقاطعة أنتاريو، بعض المقاطعات حطت قوانين أخرى ومعظمها
سوري دكتور بس مشان توضيح، الأوساب في منه جزئين اللي هو الستودنت لون اللي القرض اللي بياخذوه الطلاب في كندا كلياته، منه جزئين، جزء بروفينشال وجزء فيدرالي. فهو حكى على الجزء الفيدرالي، الجزء الفيدرالي اي احد غيروها للكل، ما ضروري تدفعه الان لحد، هاي اول نقطه، ما ضروري تدفعه لحتى تلاقي شغل، وبعد ما تلاقي شغل لازم يكون شغلك باكثر من 35,000 لحتى تضطر تدفعه، فهي نقطه حلوه. وبشكل عام اللي عليه دفعات هلا صار عليه ديفرال، يعني هلا اي ثينك
تاجيل تاجيل 6 اشهر. يس طبعا موضوع الكهرباء والماء والغاز حكى عنهم هلا سام، المواصلات صارت في معظم المدن مجانيه عشان يخففوا السوشيال ديستانس خاصه مع السائقين ولازم تدخل من الخلف. سؤال كان هل سيتم انزال الجيش؟ لانه في ناس للاسف مش عم بياخذوا الموضوع بجديه وبياخذوه بمزحه. حكى انه راح يحكي مع النواب وراح يحكي مع الحكومه، وقد تاخذ الحكومه اجراءات اكثر صرامه وتؤدي الى يعني مخالفات للناس اللي ما بتستمع لكن لحد الان طبعا لسه الموضوع مش واضح في الجراي اريا زي ما بيحكوا. سؤال كان هل سيتم اغلاق كامل؟ قال انه طبعا احنا سنوصل لهذا الكلام والحكومه عم تدرس هذا الشيء، لكن
كل الحلول على الطاوله.
يس كل الحلول على الطاوله، لكن ما في اي شيء واضح انه نحكي اليوم، لانه كثير ناس سالت عن هذا السؤال وسام وعملوا بيتيشن عن الموضوع وعم بحاولوا انهم يضغطوا، نضغط جميعا على الحكومه انه تسوي هذا الشيء، لانه اعتقد هو الشيء الاصح الان.
دكتور معلش عم يضيع وقتنا، يعني سوري انا وانت قاعدين في البيت، طيب قاعدين في البيت، طيب هل بلشت النقطه الصفر زيرو زون زيرو مثل ما بيقولوا؟ نو مش بلشت، لانه هي بتبلش لما الكل بيكونوا مع بعض، لكن انا قاعد في البيت لكن في ناس برا عم ينقلوا العدوى لبعض وعم ينقلوا الفيروس لبعض، يعني سوري عم تضيع وقتي وعم تضيع وقت اللي قاعدين في البيت ونحن كلياتنا مخنوقين، يعني سوري.
بدل ما نقعد 3 أسابيع رح نقعد 3 أشهر في الموضوع.
يا وأنا بالنسبة لإلي في عندي نصيحة للناس بشكل عام دكتور، هيك من باب الدردشة، اتعودت هلا إنه أنا متعود طول حياتي بلبس وبطلع على المكتب، فصرت هلا آخذ شاور الصبح وأحلق وألبس وأقعد في البيت، فأولادي بيقولوا لي طالع بابا، بقول لهم لا ماني طالع بس خلوني حاسس حالي كأني طالع.
صحيح. يعني الواحد شو بده يسوي؟ بده يتأقلم شوي، إن شاء الله يعني تمر هاي المرحلة. آخر سؤال كان عن موضوع المطارات، هل يوجد أي تغييرات وهل الحكومة عم تأخذ الأمور بأكثر جدية في المطارات لأنه هي المدخل لكندا؟ طبعا حكى فعلا في تغييرات صارت، وكل يوم عن يوم تتغير الأشياء. الموضوع يعني حكى سام انه في بعض الفيديوز او اللي انتشرت على السوشيال ميديا انه المطارات مش عم تاخذ الجديه في ذلك. ان شاء الله طبعا وصلوا المسج وحكى انه طبعا من الشغلات اللي صارت انهم اغلقوا جميع المطارات للرحلات الدوليه الا اربع مطارات اللي هي فانكوفر تورونتو مونتريال وكالجاري، واما باقي الامور راح تكون داخل كندا من مطار داخلي لمطار داخلي.
اضاف شغلي دكتور، اضاف شغلي انه هو متاكد كما شاف انه الشيء عم يتغير شوي شوي، فكمان امن المطار والناس المتابعين للمطار عم يغيروا شوي شوي، فقال لك انه الموضوع عم يتغير شوي شوي. انا وصلني عائله سوريه خلال 48 ساعه الماضيه، وهدول العائله لحالهم قصه لانه الاب لاجئ جاي على البلد من 5 سنين، ومن ثم بناته كانوا على الانين في مطار لمده 3 ايام، والحمد لله رب العالمين اعطاني الشرف والفضل اني سمعتهم، ويمكن يطلعوا لايف ويحكوا في يوم من الايام. وصار شغله هيومانيتيريان من اوفيسر في فرنسا، يعني بنص الليل صحاني أبوهم للبنات الساعة 3 الصبح، ويشهد الله ضليت عم بشتغل معاه للساعة 7 الصبح. وفي أوفيسر من فرنسا الحمد لله رب العالمين اللي هو كوميونيكيشن أوفيسر بالإميجريشن وافق أنهم يدخلوا على البلد، وهذه على فكرة أنا بحكيها مشان ما تكون عامة للناس، هذه مش ستاندرد، ما حدش يحاولها، هاي عم بقول دخلوا على البلد بدون وجود بي آر، يعني المحاميين اللي بشتغل معهم قالوا لي مستحيل سام ما حيدخلوا، لكن الحمد لله رب العالمين كان في هيومانيتيريان ودخلوهم للبنات على البلد وشايفوا أبوهم بعد انقطاع 5 سنين ما شافهم، صاروا تين إيجر، فكانت يعني قصة مفرحة جدا الحمد لله.
أكيد أنا دكتور ذر نسام لازم أروح، في عندي لايف تاني مع
مع مين يلا مشان نتابع
جن مع حبايب ما تشوفه فادي.
يعني دكتور شكرا كثير. دكتور جمال الشريف عنده قناة اليوتيوب تبعه، أرجوكم المتابعة، متابعة القناة متابعته. شكرا كثير لكل المشاهدين معنا، وبنشوفكم بحلقات قادمة خلال الأيام القادمة. شكرا
إن شاء الله. أهلا وسهلا فيكم
في أمان الله.